Antipsychotic medications are powerful drugs that are used to treat more than psychotic conditions like schizophrenia. Many of them are FDA-approved to treat bipolar disorder and depression. Even though they work very well and fast, they have some big side effects like weight gain and insulin resistance, some more than others. A new research study has given us some insight on which ones are better and worse when it comes to these side effects. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. We've known that antipsychotic medications cause weight gain, but what wasn't clear was, is the weight gain dose dependent? Dose dependent means that the more you take, the more weight you gain. A binary model is where it doesn't matter how much you take. If you take any of it, you'll gain weight. And until now, it wasn't clear whether or not the dose mattered. A study published in the Journal of Clinical Psychiatry in February of this year analyzed 52 randomized controlled trials, which included 22,000 people taking different antipsychotic medications. And here's what they found. All of the medications they studied had a dose-dependent relationship with weight gain, meaning higher doses caused more weight gain. However, some medications plateaued so that you gained weight up until a certain point, then it leveled off, even if your dose continued to increase. The worst situation is where there's a creep effect, and this is where your weight continues to increase with higher doses, and you can continue to gain weight the longer you take the medication, even if your dose doesn't increase. So that's the backdrop of how these medications can work. Here are 10 of the medications that were studied, ranked in order of most weight gaining to the least. This list does not include the injectable forms, and weight is in pounds rounded up. Number one is olanzapine, brand name Zyprexa. Clinically, this is not a surprise. This drug has been around for over 20 years, and we knew it caused weight gain. But what was interesting to see was more details about the weight gain. Olanzapine caused a weight gain of 8 pounds in 6 weeks, and it has the creep effect, where you can continue to gain weight for as long as you stay on the medication, even after you get to your maintenance dose. Gaining 8 pounds in 6 weeks is 1.3 pounds a week, which is 69 pounds in a year. I have seen people put on that much weight, but not everyone does. Some people plateaued around 10 to 20 pounds, but that's still a lot of weight. I don't use it as much because of this problem. I used it back when we didn't have a whole lot of other options. You may be thinking,
why would this drug even still be on the market? And why would doctors continue to prescribe it?
Because not all of these medications work the same for everyone. Sometimes olanzapine is the only thing that is effective for the person, or they started on it before the newer drugs came out. And then sometimes switching to a different antipsychotic just doesn't work. Number two is paliperidone, brand name Invega. It caused a 4 pound weight gain over 6 weeks. Like olanzapine, the weight gain did not stabilize, but continued to increase. Number three is quetiapine immediate release, brand name Seroquel. It caused a 4 pound weight gain over 6 weeks, and the weight stabilized around the 600 milligram dose. Here's an important point about this finding. Quetiapine is unique in that low doses under 100 milligrams are commonly used to help people with anxiety and sleep. The drug is not habit-forming and works very well, especially for anxiety. A typical anxiety dose is 25 to 50 milligrams. This study looked at doses starting at 75 milligrams, so it's not clear if these tiny doses affect weight much. In my own experience, patients taking these small doses didn't notice weight gain. If you want to look into using quetiapine this way, you'll have to speak to your doctor, of course, but you would still need to keep up with regular medical checks with blood work to make sure that the quetiapine is not affecting your metabolic functioning, like increasing your glucose, triglycerides, or cholesterol. Number four is risperidone, brand name Risperidone. It caused a 3 pound weight gain over 5 weeks, and the weight gain levels off between 3 and 4 milligrams. Number five is quetiapine extended release. It caused a 3 pound weight gain over 6 weeks. The weight gain peaks around the 400 milligram dose, after which you get less weight gain at the higher doses. Quetiapine extended release is not as sedating as the immediate release, and because of this, it's not as good as the immediate release is for treating anxiety and sleep. It's designed to help people be able to take it during the day and still feel alert. Number six is Acinapine, brand name Safras. It caused a 3-pound weight gain also over 6 weeks, and the weight gain levels off between the 5 and 6 milligram dose. Number seven is Brexpiprazole, brand name Rexulti. It caused a 2-pound weight gain over 6 weeks at doses up to 2 milligrams. The weight levels off and is less if you take 3 to 4 milligrams. Number eight is aripiprazole, brand name Abilify. It caused a 2-pound weight gain over 5 weeks at doses up to 30 milligrams. The weight gain was still happening at 5 weeks, which means it has the potential to keep going, but not a given that it will continue to creep up if you stay on the same dose. I've used a lot of Abilify and mostly use it in dose ranges between 5 and 15 milligrams for bipolar disorder and depression. Most of my patients didn't continue to gain weight, but some did. The higher doses of 20 to 30 milligrams tend to be used more for schizophrenia. Number nine is cariprazine, brand name Vraylar. It caused a 2-pound weight gain over 6 weeks at a dose of 4.5 milligrams. There was less weight gain with the higher doses. Number 10, and the one with the least amount of weight gain, drum roll please. Lurasidone, brand name Latuda. It caused a 1-pound weight gain over 6 weeks at a dose of 60 milligrams. Higher doses caused less weight gain. Usually bipolar disorder and schizophrenia require more than 60 milligrams, so that's good news there. These medications can also change your metabolic profile in a dose-dependent manner. That is, they can increase your glucose, triglycerides, and cholesterol. Just like weight, some medications have a better metabolic profile than others. If you want more detail on the individual medications' metabolic effects and information on the injectables, join my mental wellness space, where I'll have a handout summarizing all of this information. It's a lot of information. How can we use this information? Some people really need to take these medications, but we can first look to try and use ones that with the least amount of weight and metabolic changes. What these findings establish is that for most of these medications, the higher the dose, the more weight gain. There were a few exceptions where the higher dose didn't result in more weight gain. So this means you and your doctor can aim to use the least effective dose possible to minimize the negative effects. Sometimes the medication strategy will be to get you up to a higher dose than you may need at the moment to keep you from having breakthrough symptoms later. But with this new information, we should look to keep your dose as low as possible. You may need a somewhat high dose in the acute phase when you have the most symptoms, but once your symptoms improve, your doctor may want to see if they can lower your dose just a little for your maintenance dose, especially if you're on one of the medications that doesn't level off but keeps increasing your weight over time. For more on this topic, take a look at this video that I did on metabolic syndrome. Thanks for watching. See you next time.